we talk about blood-brain barrier. That what is blood-brain barrier first of all, and where these glutes are present, right? For let's suppose this is your central nervous system, right? Just imagine this is hypothetical vascular system. Blood is coming from here to the central nervous system, and from here it is leaving. This is the arterial end, and this is the venous end. And here should be the capillaries, right? Now, what is blood-brain barrier exactly? Yes, what is blood-brain barrier? It is some sort of barriers there, concrete barrier or plastic barriers, or what kind of barriers are these? Blood-brain barrier, yes.
Some of the substances present in blood cannot enter the brain, and likewise.
She says some of the substances present in the blood, they cannot enter in the brain because they're hitting their head against the blood-brain barrier. But what is blood-brain barrier? I know sometimes we are absorbing knowledge. You mean that if we are not understanding the knowledge, blood-brain barrier is very strong? What is blood-brain barrier? In physical aspect.
It is a membrane.
It's a membrane. Very good. It's a, some sort of membrane. What membrane?
The capillary membrane.
Capillary membrane, yes. And very good. You are right. Capillary membrane. Yes, very right. Let me tell you, she is right. That blood-brain barrier, if I remove this piece from here, this piece, I put it here, basically, number one, there are endothelial cells, right? Now these are endothelial cells lining the capillaries of central nervous system, right? Okay, I put it like that. Now, from here blood is entering, from here it is entering, and here it is leaving. Now, here is the neuron. This is your beautiful neuron, axon, and these are what? Dendrites. If glucose, this glucose molecule has to eventually reach inside the neuron, first it has to cross from the blood up to the interstitial fluid of central nervous system. And then from the interstitial fluid of central nervous system, it has to cross the neuronal membranes and enter into neuron. Now, first barrier is here. This is blood-brain barrier. Now, what are the components of blood-brain barrier? Number one, there are endothelial cells having tight junctions. Tight junctions mean that, yes, they don't allow many things to go through the interendothelial gap. They don't allow many substances to go through the interendothelial gaps. So if this is the glucose molecule, right, it is very sad rather, because it has to pass through such tough lining of endothelial. Secondly, under these endothelial, if it pass, there is basement membrane, there is basement membrane. And within the basement membrane, there may be some special type of cells which are called pericytes. These are called pericytes, right? So it means any substance which has to leave the blood of cerebral capillaries or central nervous system capillaries and go to the extracellular fluid, that has to pass through the endothelial lining. Then it has to pass through the basement membrane, and where at many places what are present? Pericytes. And then they have to cross one more thing. What is that? That is, I'm actually telling you the structure of blood-brain barrier. These are your cells. Okay. These are astrocytes. Right? These are astrocytes. Astrocytes have many, many foot processes. They have many, many foot processes. And these foot processes do a lot of functions. But one of the functions is these foot processes come and here they expand. These are foot processes of astrocytes, right? Now, these podocytes or foot processes, they are making an additional barrier, right? Which certain substances have to cross to reach to the interstitial fluid, and then of course, neurons are here. right? Now, for central nervous system, glucose is very important. For central nervous system, glucose is very, very, it is must for energy metabolism. But if glucose level is low, then they can, central nervous system, because of very VIP tissue, so it should be able to use some alternative fuels, right? Glucose is the preferred fuel of central nervous system. This neuron needs glucose. But if due to some reason it cannot get the glucose, the alternative fuel is?
Ketone.
They are not fatty acids. Why? Because fatty acids in the blood are attached with albumin and pre-albumin molecules. And albumin and pre-albumin molecule cannot cross blood-brain barrier. Right? So, as alternative fuel, alternative to glucose, your neurons cannot use
fatty acids.
Fatty acids. If they cannot use the fatty acids, it means then last option left is ketone bodies. Ketone bodies. What are the names of ketone bodies? Ketone bodies have nothing to do with the cats. Yes. Ketone bodies. Acetoacetate, beta hydroxybutyrate, and acetone. Acetone is metabolically dead. So we can say basically two important ketone bodies which can be used as fuel in the body systems are acetoacetate and beta hydroxybutyrate. Beta hydroxybutyrate. So what I'm saying, so preferred fuel here is glucose. So glucose somehow has to reach inside this cell. Now it has to cross this structure, which is called blood. Here is blood, and here is brain environment, right? This whole structure is called blood-brain barrier. So physically, if you talk about blood-brain barrier, it consists of endothelial cells in central nervous system capillaries, which are having very strong tight junctions. They are the most important component of blood-brain barrier. Outside that, we have basement membrane with pericytes in it, and more outside if you go, there are there is a layer consisting of food processes derived from the astrocytes. Is that right? Now, glucose has to go through this. Now, most tight point here for the glucose is endothelial cells. So, where should be the glutes? On endothelial cells of blood-brain barrier. Now, because glucose is very important, do you think there should be glute 1 and 3 there, or rather, I will remodify my question. Do you think there should be glute with high affinity or with low affinity there?
High affinity.
So there must be glute 1, right? So actually, in fact, glute 1 is present on endothelial cells of blood-brain barrier, and glute 1 have how much km? 1 millimolar, approximately 1 to 2 millimole per liter. It means even if blood glucose level is low, still some glucose can go through this barrier, right? And now I think it's very right time to mention, once glucose passes through these layers, then it has to enter into neuron, right? Again, I will repeat, here were endothelial cells, and then there was basement membrane with pericytes, and then there were foot processes of astrocytes. But once glucose, here was which channels? Glute 1, and once glucose has reached here, it wants to enter inside. Here there should be another glucose transporter. Yes. As I mentioned, glucose is polar and larger molecule, and it cannot enter across the membranes very efficiently. So from here, if glucose has to cross, if I say that here is not glute 1, then which glute should be here?
Glute 3.
Yes, very true. There must be glute 3. So neurons, neuronal membrane, the dendrite or axons, they are decorated with glute 3, and blood-brain barrier is decorated with glute 1. So what did we learn? That central nervous system loves to have glucose. It's very preferred fuel is glucose, and to get the glucose, it has to get the glucose across the blood-brain barrier, where the help will be taken by
glute 1.
And get the glucose across the neuronal membranes, where there should be glute
3.
And these glutes should be low affinity or high affinity?
High affinity
and low KM. Is that right?
Yes.